The only way I can be beat is if you cheat. If you cheat. If you play fair and square, I'm going to win. I mean.
Hey, what up, babes? Welcome back. It's Barb City, where it be litty. Let's go on ahead and get into it. Before we do, as always, remember, when in doubt, pull your mother effing blunt out. All right. Our first topic is going to be about Glorilla. Y'all already know I do not F with her, but I don't have a problem with giving somebody, you know, they tens or saying congratulations when it's due. So it looks like Memphis has recognized Glorilla. They did give her the key to the city, as you guys can see here. So like I said, the following sloth does get on my nerves just a little bit, but congratulations to her on that.
Could never give you a 10 because I don't like you. So bro, I always got to keep something negative in reference to you. So I can never give you a, you can never get that 10.
Now, with that being said, let's go on ahead and move forward into Ice Spice. So it looks like Ice Spice has been losing some followers over on Instagram. Not just that, but it looks like she lost a large amount after what happened with her and Cleo on tour hit the internet. So as you guys can see, it says Ice Spice has now lost over 540,000 followers in the last 12 days on Instagram. And it also says she has lost 8,000 followers today, which was the day the situation happened with Cleo hit the internet. So you guys, I don't know. Let me know if you guys are someone who has unfollowed Ice Spice. I unfollowed a long time ago. Like, it's giving opportunists and the whole devil worshiping thing. I just can't get with that. But Akbar V decided to weigh in on the situation with Ice Spice and Cleo, y'all. She did have a lot to say. She basically said if it was her in that position, she would have put some pause on Ice Spice. So she said, I'm not going to lie. If all that happened how Cleo said it did, I would have the F out of Ice Spice, and it's the security, so he couldn't break it up. I would have maced the security first. Why am I blocking out the security and leaving the word mace? Anyway, this is a prime example on why you better know who your friends are. I ain't going for none of that. So you guys already know Akbar V is very good at, you know, inserting herself in situations, but let me know what you guys feel about what she had to say. And also let me know what you guys feel about Ice Spice losing so many followers. Okay, let's move forward into Ari Fletcher. So Ari Fletcher was doing an interview. The interviewer was being very much inappropriate and disrespectful. You can tell by Ari's responses to the interviewer that she was not only uncomfortable, but she felt disrespected. And he just kept going and going, you guys. He went as far as to ask her if he can eat her pet. Check this out.
I saw Kristen on here with
Ari to die.
Hey, look, can you rate my drip like 1 through 10? You know, this is something slight. You know what I'm saying? Real pressure, though.
Okay, I'll give you like an 8.
A 10?
I'll give you an 8.
A 10.
My homegirl said, ain't you?
I had a 10. I like you, too. So, look, would you date a dude dressed like this?
No.
Yeah, I date you too. So look, can you like a 360 for the camera?
Absolutely not.
One time for the camera? For the culture?
Stop fucking playing. I said no. Next question.
Okay. Can I grab?
Let's go to the car. Thank you. That's it. Do your next question.
I want you to do a 360.
I said no, so it's next, right?
Yeah.
You do a 360. Look at that. Ass. Look at that. Wait, move. You do a 360.
Okay.
Alright, turn that shit over. Shake that shit.
No, let me see.
No, shake that
wait.
Shit.
Let me see.
No, shake that shit.
Okay, let me ask the last question.
Shake that. Alright.
Can it clap?
Can what clap?
That.
What?
You can clap your
hands. What?
Can I eat?
Huh?
Can I eat?
I can't hear you.
You heard me.
So, in my opinion, that was very uncomfortable to watch. And the comments made it even more uncomfortable. People were saying things like, well, some of the comments, people were saying things like, that end is mad weird. The lady said no, then follow up with some freaky-ish weirdo A-N. This end is so corny to me, LOL. Why y'all make bruh viral? I hate y'all for that. What? This is a first. She shakes her bare A in front of men any other time. So you guys would be surprised how many comments there were, like the last one that I just read. And it does not matter when she's shaking her very own butt and who she's doing it in front of. If she's ever uncomfortable and she says no, then that's what the F it is. Okay. But anyways, let me know what you guys feel about that. And let's go on ahead and move forward into Erica Banks. So Erica Banks has the internet very, very much upset because she took it upon herself to disrespect the F out of rich homie Quan's family and his girlfriend, okay? So, as you guys probably already know, rich homie Quan has, you know, passed on, unfortunately. That was so sad to hear, you guys. I'm not even going to lie. I was so shocked about this. But unfortunately, like I said, rich homie Quan is no longer here. And Erica Banks thought it would be a good time to try and expose the relationship that she was having with him, even though rich homie Quan was keeping her a secret, basically. So, as you guys can see, it says, heartbreaking audio released of 911 call from rich homie Quan's longtime girlfriend. She found him without a heartbeat on the couch. She said, I can't see him breathing. So, you guys, that call is very much disturbing. But without saying too much about it, because you guys know how Barb City is about speaking on people's passings, we're just going to go right into what Erica Banks did. So can we begin with the fact that she blocked me? As y'all can see here, I went to go get the tea, you guys, and I found out that she blocked me, as if I care. But it's like, what the F I do? You know what I'm saying? But anyway, as you guys can see here, the Shade Room did post that she did delete this post from her Instagram. So this post about rich homie Quan that I'm about to read you guys is no longer up on her platform, okay? But this is what she said. All you wanted was to find happiness again. I always saw it in your face and heard it in your voice. But you had so much left to do. The album, the tour, your birthday. I'm just glad we were able to enjoy such peaceful and memorable moments while you were here, man. Such a sweetheart. Rest in paradise, Quan. Now, this would not be a problem to post had Quan let the world know that he was messing with you, especially, you know, considering the fact that his girlfriend that he has been with for a long time that you obviously knew about just found him. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's clear attention seeking, and you obviously don't really care about this man. But let me play this video that she also posted along with what I just read you. Check this out. She also went as far as to post some of their text messages where he told her, confession, I've liked you for a minute, but who wants to get rejected? Then I saw you talking to blank, but in my head, you've been mine. None of them ends deserve you. And here were some of the comments. If you was a secret before the passing, stay a secret afterwards. Don't me the F off. No matter what he did behind closed doors, he had a family who is currently grieving him. This was so tasteless. Girl, bye. Another person said, I just want to say, Erica, you are wrong. I see you done deleted it, but you know folks already done screenshot it. Why post this now? You've been Wizard Kellying that man. He has a family. Why break the heart of his girlfriend even more on this day? She already done lost her granny. Now her man's kids or her man slash kids father. We don't care if you had dealings with him. Everyone know Quan has had his moments, but girl, today wasn't the day. I'm pretty sure y'all had a side-by-side pic. All those videos you uploading like that was your real man is crazy. I like you and I still do, but girl, this was so wrong. If he was a secret, they continue to keep him a secret. And I agree with this. It's like, why break that woman's heart even more just to let the world know that y'all was messing around if y'all didn't care that the world knew while he was here, right? Yet again, y'all, like I told you guys before, Akbar V always has to insert herself into things. So she did have an opinion on this, y'all, and this is what she had to say. Hold on. I understand you might be hurt, but baby girl, delete those pics and videos out of respect for his family, man. You was a secret, and not saying what y'all shared was fake, but certain stuff should remain a secret because here comes all the unwanted hate towards you that you didn't even know existed. Think before you do stuff. So, you guys, I stand with Akbar V and everybody else on this situation. I feel like she was completely out of line, but let me know what you guys feel about it. Again, RIP to Rich Homie Quan. So upsetting. Let's go on ahead and move forward into Bia just really quick, you guys. Y'all know Bia did attend Gag City Philly last night with Nicki Minaj, and she basically let it be known that she had a great time. She did not have her in Ice Spice situation, so she said, we had a blast, B. Thank you. Hashtag Gag City Philly. So just really quick, congratulations to Bia. I love that for her. I did see a lot of her videos going around with Nicki Minaj's as far as her performance went. So again, I'm happy for Bia. Excuse me. I feel like she deserves this out of all the girls. So yeah, enjoy yourself, boo. And let me go on ahead and give you your mother effing flowers out.
Just give a bitch her roses, though. I mean,
you know I love
just
you,
give man. A bitch her roses, though. You know what I'm saying?
Now, let's go on ahead and get into this Megan Thee Stallion and Nicki Minaj BS, okay? I did avoid talking about this yesterday because I felt like Megan Thee Stallion and Roc Nation were simply trying to get into Nicki Minaj's algorithm. So that's why I waited so long. But anyways, Megan Thee Stallion was doing an interview and she basically said in the interview that she has no idea why her and Nicki Minaj were ever beefing, okay? When she was asked if there could ever be, you know, another collaboration or reconcile between the two of them. So as you guys can see here, it says, oop, Megan Thee Stallion says she doesn't know why Nicki Minaj dislikes her. I don't even know what can be reconciled because I still to this day don't know what the problem is. So I find that very interesting, you guys. This is the article right here, just so y'all know I ain't making it up. But it's just like, Megan, come on now. I'm just gonna refresh you guys' minds before we get into the comments, right? It is not only the fact that Nicki Minaj let Megan Thee Stallion know that she was trying to get pregnant and there was a possibility that she was pregnant. She was obviously hiding it from her fans, but Megan Thee Stallion kept disrespecting her on live by telling her to drink with her. And not just that, when Nicki Minaj was denying when she denied wanting to drink with Megan Thee Stallion, Megan then told her to go to the clinic, basically saying, get rid of Papa Bear, right? So that was one. Two was the fact that Nicki Minaj gave Megan Thee Stallion a free verse, you guys. Hot Girl Summer, Nicki Minaj gave her that verse for free. She asked Megan Thee Stallion to do one thing, and that was to go to Queen Radio and freestyle, okay? And Megan Thee Stallion did not hold up her part of the deal and instead turned around and did a collaboration with Cardi B short after, where she was out of nowhere shading Nicki Minaj. So that's where the drama came from, and Megan Thee Stallion does know that. And we're not going to sit here and act like this was not pre-planned for this story to come out the day that Nicki Minaj starts her second leg, okay? With that being said, let's go on ahead and get into some of the comments. How you don't know what the problem is, but you dissed her and came for her husband on a song? LMAO, that makes zero sense, but it's crazy. They released this today. Nicki starts her tour back today. They'll do anything to be in her algorithm. And that is exactly what the F I thought when I saw that, okay? Another person said, let me take a mother effing breath, child, is what another person said. You kept offering her liquor when she was pregnant. And when she expressed that to you, you laughed in her face and told her to go to the clinic. Are we in the Twilight Zone? You knew she wasn't ready to announce her pregnancy, yet you kept trying to offer her liquor on live, making things awkward. And keep in mind, Bigfoot is a response diss, not something Nicki just woke up doing. Anyway, Nicki is busy touring. Three more comments saying, these girls love acting clueless. She told you, babe. She said she was hiding her pregnancy, and she told you that, and you kept offering her on live. One more comment. So why you make a diss song? And that's just that, because it's like a person can be dissing me all day. If they don't say my name, if it ain't directed, it ain't respected, right? You knew there was beef. You knew she was talking to you, and you knew why. At the end of the day, you need to stand on mother effing business, child. And until next time, thank you for enjoying Barb City mother effing blooper rolls. I love you guys so much. Hey!